Hi, in this video we're going to talk about how to use our calculator to find the mean and the standard deviation of a probability distribution. So this goes with the notes for section 5.2. So here we've got an example. It says there are five children in one family. So the random variable is the number of girls that are in that family. So here we have our distribution. And we want to find the mean and the standard deviation. So we'll turn our calculator on, clear out of this. Okay, and the first thing we're going to do is put our data values in, just like you've done to find the mean or the standard deviation before. So you hit stat and edit, and we're going to put the x values into L1. Remember, if you need to clear, you go up to the top, hit clear and enter. So we're going to put the x values here, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we're going to put the p of x values into L2, so 0.0313, 0.156, 0.312, 0.156, oops, sorry, you have to be careful, make sure you get it right, 0.312, 0.156, and 0.0313. Okay, now that we have those in there, you can X them out, so you can hit second, quit. Okay, go back to the home screen. Now we're going to hit stat, go over to calc, and choose one variable stats, just like you've done. Now, this is what you'll see if you have an 84. We'll talk about if you have an 83, it's just going to go back to the home screen and say one var stats, and we'll talk about that in a minute. So here you're going to leave the list L1 and then the frequency list, you're going to hit, we want to put an L2 there. So you're going to hit second, see it says list above stat, so second stat, and then hit L2. Okay, then you can hit calculate. And the first one, the X bar, that's our mean. And then our standard deviation, sigma X, is down here. So that gives you the mean and the standard deviation. Now, if you have a TI-83, it's just going to say one var stats. After that, you would hit second stat L1, then put a comma, so it'll say one var stats. I can't make mine say that right now, but one var stats, L1, comma, second stat L2, and then you would hit enter, and it will give you that same thing. Okay, so you're putting the values into L1 and L2, and then doing the one variable statistics.